guys.
Hi.
You did this. Have you been to Denver?
No, no. Oh, okay. Did I do that?
Right.
It's like, weird. Hey, I instantly go to the sports franchises associated. So I just literally, yeah.
Okay. Do you have anything to say about the
Broncos? Broncos, Rockies, right. I just check Nuggets.
So where are you going with that? You about to follow up with something else?
No. Okay. I'm not sure.
All right. So I have to ask. First of all, everybody wants to know what you get yelled at the most when you're on the street. Do you hear victory?
Well, I get the victory, of course.
Okay. And do you get turtled?
I get turtled. I get a lot of people want to smoke weed with me. I mean, this is for Denver, right?
I was going to say,
so
do you
want
to say that? That's why I thought maybe you had
Colorado,
been to Denver.
Yeah.
You know, we actually probably both get the hug it out. It wasn't even our line.
Hug it out.
You guys
are
like, hey, come on,
hug it out.
Dudes want to throw you in a choke.
Right, right. Yeah. Is there ever a time where, like, living in Hollywood, it became this... Oh, too many women. There's just, I can't deal with this anymore. Too many cars, too much money.
That's what we call Cadillac problems.
I'm growing up.
Know? It's never really too much of a problem.
Right.
Yeah, and look, I'll be the one to say it. The characters lived a lot larger than I think we all did in our own lives. So I don't think we were ever like, oh, there's too many women and cars and money
around. I'm over
around.
This. Like, I'm just going to stay in and watch a movie.
We are kind of homebodies. Yeah. Hate to disappoint anyone. But.
Well, I read that you're like the most domesticated of the cast.
I guess. I'd like to know who was attached to that quote. No.
I'm going to throw Connelly.
Probably Connelly.
For that one.
Right?
I hid a lot in the house. But we all have that homebodiness. But
yeah, I'm a bit of a hermit myself.
We've had our share of fun, too.
Okay, so that like do you guys are you around the set? I know you're really good friends with the cat or with the crew as well and stuff.
Of course.
Are you guys the guys that are always like helping them out? Let me help you with that light. You guys seem like you're that humble guy.
We love the crew, but we don't really help them move the lights around.
I think our biggest help is always we want to come prepared to get everyone out of there as quick as possible.
Okay,
I think that's
cool.
Also
Show up,
the biggest favor.
Know your lines, hit your mark, and. The crew will be real happy. They'll get to go home early.
Yeah, that's the best thing you can do for any crew is come in prepared so we're not here for an extra 3 hours while you try to spit your lines out.
That means a lot to them.
Yeah, I think so.
Yeah, it does. Okay, now I have to ask you really fast, Kevin, the whole TMZ thing that happens in the show, one of my favorite TMZ moments in real life was when your car died. Because one, my dog looks just like your dog. So I was like, I love that dog. You had the old school truck. And
I
then
got
all
a
of a sudden,
you American you're... Bulldogs. I don't know if you saw it yet.
I didn't see it. No,
I was
didn't
really
see
nice
it.
To the TMZ guys. And it's a 68
you were so cool about
Chevy
it.
Short bed pickup
right.
truck. And I just took it out for the first time in
and
a while.
It died
my
on you?
Battery died. So I'm talking to the guys from TMZ. I jump into my car. I got my dogs with me.
It's like, oh,
and,
God.
So I'm trying to get the thing started, and they just kept the camera on me just a little bit too long. It's like, all right, F off.
He did. He said that. He was like,
you know
in
what?
Front of TMZ, too.
You know what? The guys are great, too. The guy actually, after he put the, he goes, finally, you know, he put the camera down.
He gave you a jump?
He's like, and I was like, do you have jumper cables?
Right.
And he goes, yeah, let me go get them.
Oh, good.
Thank God.
Got
I was
the,
wondering what part two was.
You know, they're actually really cool. I mean, I'm stuck in Malibu where TMZ seems to be. They must all live there. I don't know. There's so many TMZ guys, but I've gotten to know these guys now. But it was nice enough for this guy to jump me.
Yeah.
That sounded really wrong.
To jump my car.
Okay, jump to, do you jump care about the tabloids, what you read in the paper and stuff?
I actually used to a lot more. Not even necessarily like the tabloids. I was always very sensitive to like what people would say about the show more so. I've come to terms with the fact that some people are going to say nice things about you. Some people are going to say mean things about you. Some will be true, some won't, and you can't please everyone, so just ignore it. Just live your life. Don't live by that.
Right. That is actually the way to live for anybody, famous or not.
Famous or not.
Exactly.
I don't even look at him.
Yeah.
I don't even look at him. And someday I'll get to Fat Sal's.
You
I totally will.
That's awesome.
Yes.